Hey everyone, I'm Jamie and welcome back. Today we're diving into something super cool that's been making waves in the AI world, Nano Banana. No, it's not a new fruit, it's actually the code name for a massive upgrade to Google's Gemini app, specifically its image editing features. We're talking next level AI editing that promises to preserve identity, blend photos, and make complex edits unbelievably simple. I'm excited to put it to the test. So what exactly is Nano Banana? Well, according to Google, it's a new image editing model from Google DeepMind that's built into Gemini. Its main goal is to be incredibly smart about how it edits, especially when it comes to keeping the likeness of subjects. Think of your face, your dog's face, or even a specific object consistent no matter how much you change the scene around it. This is a huge deal because often with AI, things can get a little bit inconsistent, but Nano Banana aims to fix that. I've got some prompts ready. Let's go. I'm going to be demoing this from my Gemini app that I'm logged into. You can also go over to Google AI Studio, and here it is right here, Gemini native image with Gemini 2.0 flash. So you can use it in a few different ways. So let's start off with the first one is how it can preserve the image. So I'm going to open up this image. I'm going to drag it in here. This one right here. I just took a quick picture of me, my office, my messy office, and I'm just going to drag this over into Gemini and let's start. And what I like about this, the few times I've done this, I can make my prompts pretty simple. And it's kind of this conversation that's happening. Let's send this off. Okay, that took about 10 seconds. Let's see what we have here. Let's make this a little larger. So it definitely kept the likeness of my face and it changed everything around. I see the sunset, the city, cyberpunk in the outfit. So that did a pretty good job. So what I'm thinking right now that's going in my mind, this is going to be such an easy way to make thumbnails on YouTube just by changing the image and how quickly this happens. Let's see how else we can change this. We'll just hit back and we're just going to give a quick new prompt using the same image of me. Place me in a magical forest sitting on a giant mushroom. Give me a fantasy elf-like outfit. We'll send that off. So here's the magical update. You can see I'll click on it and we have the face preserved, the background, the giant mushroom. Everything is there. I'm impressed with how quick that happened and it starts giving me ideas of how a lot of people are going to use this. Next, we're going to tackle photo blending and a new feature called design mixing. This sounds like it could save hours in photo editing suites. I have two different pictures I'm going to drag in, a cozy living room and some modern art. You're going to see between the two of them, I don't really think that this art will match this, but we'll see what happens. I'm going to say blend the modern art sculpture in the living room, making it look like it's natural part of the decor. Let's see what happens. Well, that doesn't look very natural, and I kind of knew that this might have some troubles trying to blend this in naturally just based on the coziness of the living room and the modern art and how big it was. But it did do a good job at cutting this out, and it put it in a spot where I thought it could fit. I thought maybe it would shrink it down and place it on the table or the mantle, but I just wanted to try this and see what would happen. Let's try another blending one. I have a coffee cup here, just a plain white coffee cup. And I have a mosaic pattern. And what I'm going to ask it to do is put the pattern onto the coffee cup. So apply the mosaic pattern from the second image onto the coffee mug, keeping the mug's original shape and texture. So we'll go ahead and send this off. Now that did a much better job. It looks like the mosaic is spot on and the coffee cup. Here's the original coffee cup. And here is the original mosaic. And this is the final result. That did a great job of blending. This could be massive for product design mockups or just personalizing items. Finally, let's explore multi-turn editing. This means you can refine your image with multiple specific commands without starting from scratch. It simulates a conversation with an editor. Here we go. I'm going to add a dog. This is a golden retriever that's playing in the park. And I'm going to ask it to change the park to a snowy mountain landscape. Let's see what happens. Well, it did place it in the right situation. It's in the mountains. It still has its frisbee. Let's try to do something else here. Let's say, using the same image, add a small, friendly looking rabbit hopping near the dog's paws. Make it look like it's a cold, overcast day. I wonder if it'll get rid of the frisbee now. Well, that's interesting. It did add the rabbit, but I don't think things look too realistic here. Let's try one more thing. I want to see if I can remove the frisbee here. Let's see what happens. All right, so it did remove the frisbee. So again, this conversation that we could have back and forth with it to get exactly what we needed. Probably I could have started with a more realistic picture, but I'm kind of impressed with how easy it is to tell what we want. It understood the context, added a new element, and even adjusted the overall mood of the image with lighting change. The ability to converse and refine is what makes this AI editing so powerful. So, what are my final thoughts on Google's Nano Banana image editing in Gemini? I'm seriously impressed. The likeness preservation is a huge leap forward, making AI edits much more reliable for subjects. The blending and the design mixtures are incredibly intuitive and open up so many creative possibilities. And multi-turn editing means you can really sculpt your vision piece by piece. Of course, like all AI, it's not always perfect, but the results we've seen today, I find them kind of mind-blowing because it was so easy to do. This feels like a significant step towards democratizing professional-level image editing for everyone. The fact that this includes Synth ID watermarks is also a responsible move by Google, helping to identify AI-generated content. What do you think of Nano Banana?